All right, the first thing we're going to do is take this nice flat paper and crinkle it all up. Crinkle, 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 crinkle it all up. And then very carefully flatten it back out. And if it tears a little bit, that's okay, but try not to let it tear. And crinkle it back up. Crinkle, crinkle, crinkle. Tight, tight, tight ball. And then tight ball, and then uncrinkle it gently. And flatten it back out nicely. And then crinkle it up. Crinkle, crinkle, crinkle it all back up. And in a nice tight ball, and then uncrinkle it. And then what you're going to do is you're going to draw an animal on it. And I'm going to draw my animal. Let's see if you can guess what it is. I'm going to start with the body and the shape of the head, add the neck and the legs. And I like to have my legs sticking out like this, so it looks like I'm looking at it from the air. It's sort of stylized, like Aboriginal paintings often are. And a big long tail like this. And then I'm going to get my eraser and I'm going to erase my guidelines, because that's what we do when we draw, is we have guidelines and then we erase what we don't need. And I'm just going to add a few, like very few embellishments, just maybe some eyes and the tongue here, widen that neck and erase my guidelines. And now I have a lizard. So here's my lizard. And then you're going to draw a couple or maybe three geometric shapes, shapes that have a name. Remember, geometric shapes are shapes that have a name. And then we're going to start adding dots. And we're going to do this Q-tips and paint. And you see how I'm not brushing it on? I am just adding dots side by side here. Lots of dots all around. And I'm just going to continue to fill this in. I'm going to fill my lizard in with green dots so that all of my lizard is green. And I'm not brushing, I'm just using dots right next to each other. I'm going to make the dots for my lizard kind of close together. And then for my embellishments on the outside, which I'll show you in a second, those are going to be further apart. So let me go ahead and finish up these dots here. All right, now it's time to outline. Now that we have finished the lizard, we're going to outline the shapes in one color. So all the shapes are going to be outlined in orange for me, although you can choose a different color than orange, but you're going to outline all the shapes in one color. And that's also going to become the first row of colors for your dots around your animal. And you fill that shape in with the same color. Oh, forgot my tongue, here we go. And now I'm going to outline my animal in orange because I made my shapes orange. So I'm going to go all around my animal here, and just using dots, I'm going to outline it. Now my dots can be a little further apart on the outline than they were for the animal. And remember, whatever animal you choose, you can choose whatever animal you want, and you could choose whatever colors you want from this palette. But this palette that we have, you might notice we don't have any purple or blue, because this is the palette that you will find in Aboriginal paintings. So now I'm going to start on my second row of colors, and my second color is going to be red. So I'm going to go red around everything here. So just a red dot, red line of, or a red, a line of red dots all the way around. And when I have a line of dots that meet up with each other, I don't overlap it, I just go around. Okay, so now my third color is going to be black. So see how I just fill in that space there with a row? I just fill in the empty space with my row of dots, and this is black dots. And I'm just gonna do an ABC pattern. So just three colors, and then green would be my animal, which would be not part of my pattern here. So once I finish the black, I'm going to finish the black, and then I would do orange. So I would make another row that would then be orange once I finish all of the black lines. All right, thank you for all your help. So I'm just continuing my row all the way around.
Okay, that's fine. Just go ahead and just put it over by that wallpaper there.
And I would just continue to make this pattern all the way around. And now, see, I'm going to start with my orange until you end up with a full, beautiful painting like this.